in this next section, we're going to be talking about stacks. Stacks are how you eat pancakes. Pancakes are pretty awesome. Stacks are how you lay out things in SwiftUI. As you can see over here, I have a stack right here on my screen. It's called a VStack. It's pretty cool. If let me tap on it, I can see the word VStack. And here's a little hint. If I tap on the curly brace, you actually get something that represents what the VStack contains. So VStack is a bit of a container view. And what it does is it takes everything inside it. In this case, it's an image and two pieces of text, and it lays them out vertically, right? So here's what I mean. Let me show you in a drawing. So I have a VStack over here, and inside I have an image. That's me, upside down me. And then I have a text, and that's this thing over here. And I have another text, that's this thing over here. Okay, so this outer container right here is called a VStack. Pardon my awful, awful handwriting. So let's return to our app. What we're going to do next is we're going to be adding an HStack. That's because we want our app to be laid out a certain way. Let me show you what I mean. So instead of having my picture on top followed by two pieces of text, I'm going to have my picture on the left with my text on the right. So it's going to look a bit like this. I'll have my image over here, and I'll have my top text here and my bottom text here. Okay. To do that, I need to have this outer thing be a HStack. And interestingly enough, we're going to need to have this still be a VStack. Okay. So I hope that makes sense. Let's try this out. First, let's go make our VStack into a HStack to see what it looks like. Right, so let's go all the way to the letter V over here. V, of course, stands for vertical, and H stands for horizontal. So I'm going to delete V and replace it with H. It's as simple as that. And you can see over here, now I have everything laid out side by side because it's an H stack. So this is item number one, this is item number two, and this is item number three. Okay, everything is laid out left to right using an HStack. And left to right is only if you're using an iOS device that is using a left to right language, because there are other languages where an HStack might go right to left. Okay, but that's fine. Let's continue with what we meant to do. So that's not quite what we want. We wanted an HStack with the image on the left and our two pieces of text on the right. So our two pieces of text on the right should be in a VStack of their own. So let's put them into a VStack. So I'm going to put my cursor over here. I'm going to press enter. And I'm going to type in a VStack, capital V, capital S, T-A-C-K. You can use the autocomplete if you want to, but this was just six letters. You can type six letters, right? And type in open curly brace, press enter. And now you have an open VStack with nothing inside it. And your app still looks exactly the same as before. So what we want to do is we want to take this piece of text and this piece of text and put them inside the VStack. So the way we're going to do this on iPad is we're going to select our text and choose cut, move our cursor inside the curly braces and choose paste. So let's do that. You can double tap on the word text to select the current view. Remember, a text is called a view, capital V. And I'm going to move this little handle to the end and tap somewhere inside the selection to activate the cut copy selection menu. Press cut, move your cursor inside, tap again, and choose paste. And there you go, right? It lands inside your VStack. I want to show you a different method, and this method I find can be a little flaky, but it's kind of fun because it's got fun little animations and might mess up your code, but let's try it anyway. So I'm going to undo. You can undo on the keyboard with Command Z. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to tap on this ending curly brace right here of the VStack. You see the two dots? The two dots indicates that it's a little handle. I'm going to drag it to include these two pieces of text. And when I let go, they're now safely ensconced inside this VStack. I can't believe I got to use the word ensconced. That's such a great word. So what's going on with these curly braces? Right, these curly braces indicate the beginning and the end of a given container. So in this VStack, the beginning of the VStack is this open curly brace right here. And the end of this VStack is this closing curly brace right here. You can treat this as you would a giant alligator, right, with the mouth, the top jaw and the bottom jaw containing some other code. Just that there are alligators containing other alligators, which makes for a strange set of imagery, but I think you get what I mean. Okay, so if you're using the regular iPad touchscreen, you just need to tap on the curly brace to see where the corresponding curly brace is when it's ending, right? So you can tap on the curly brace for VStack, right? So notice if you tap right here, right? Or if you tap right here, you can select the closing curly brace for this opening curly brace. If you're using a trackpad or a mouse, you can actually double click on the opening curly brace and you'll find that it selects it all the way to the closing curly brace. Right, so this is something to really get used to because you're going to see a whole bunch of curly braces. As you can see, we have four right here. And as you make more and more complex layouts, you're going to get more and more curly braces. All right, so just be aware of this. You're going to be nesting all these things in one after another. Before we finish up this section, I'm going to show you one more thing. I actually want my text over here to be aligned to the top of my picture. And the way we do that is by giving some parameters to my HStack. So it's like saying, hey, you, I know you can lay things out a certain way, but I want you to do it my way, right? By default, the HStack will happily align things in the center. But if we want to align it differently, you go to the end of the word HStack, press open bracket, and notice that it gives you the close bracket automatically. That's something that programming editors like to do. So you don't actually need to type the closing bracket, but if you do, it's perfectly fine as well, right? It'll just close the bracket for you. Inside here, you can type what we call an argument. So I'm going to say alignment, type colon, and we're going to choose one of various alignments. I'm going to type dot, and I'm going to choose top. This means that as you lay out this HStack, please align all the things to the top. Right, these dot things are called enums, enumerated types, which we'll talk more about in the future. There's another parameter called spacing. Let me just show you what it does. Just type a comma after top, spacing, colon. And if you can give it a spacing of, 50, what it means is that between all the different elements in the HStack, and remember there are two elements in the HStack, right? One is an image and one is a VStack. Between these two elements, leave a space of 50 points. 50 tiny little screen units, if you will. All right. We don't need this. I think it's perfectly fine to have them as close as they are by default. So I'm going to remove that. Okay, we've come to the end of this section. Thanks for joining us. I hope you were at least mildly entertained or educated or both, maybe. Is that too much to ask? I'm not sure. But I hope you learned a bit about SwiftUI and views and stuff. Thank you for watching. Check out our Think Academy website and the Swiftin SG website if you want to find out more about what we do. And please like and subscribe, and I will see you soon.